This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello there once again. Welcome to episode 54. In this episode, we're going to use the logarithm rules from the previous episode to try to solve an equation. Let's get started. All right, our problem today is log base 3 of x minus 8 equals 2 minus log base 3 of x. To solve a log equation, if you have more than one log, you need to move the logs to the same side first. So we'll say log base 3 of x. So log base 3 of x. On the right side, the log of x cancels out. And now on the left, you'll have log base 3 of x minus 8 plus log base 3 of x equals 2. Now, it's still fairly hard to solve at this point. What you're going to have to do is combine the logs together to make one log. These equations are always much easier if you only have one log to deal with rather than two. So we're going to make these two logs into one big log. You might also notice both of these logs are positive. So in our big log, which is a fraction, both of these will go on the top. We'll have x times x minus 8. We don't have any negative logs, so we have just a 1 on the bottom. All of this is still equal to 2. Now that we only have one log, we can try to clear the log. In order to clear a log, you have to take an exponential. Notice we have base 3 as our base for the log. Therefore, to clear the base 3 log, we need a 3 exponential. So we'll put a 3 underneath the log term and another 3 underneath the 2. So now we have 3 raised to the log base 3 of x times x minus 8 over 1 equals 3 raised to the second power. We can simplify this a little bit to make it look a little less ugly. Remember that if you have a 3 exponential and a log, they are inverses, which means you can cancel them both out. There's also no need to write the over 1 underneath the fraction because dividing by 1 doesn't do anything. So all we have left on the left side is x times x minus 8 equals, on the right side, 3 to the second power. Now we can simplify this a little bit further even, because we can multiply this x times both of these terms. X times x is x squared, and x times negative 8 is negative 8x, and 3 squared is simply 9. Now, instead of having a logarithmic equation, we have a quadratic equation. We've solved our share of quadratic equations already. To solve this, we need to get everything on the same side. So we'll move the 9 over by subtracting 9 from both sides. So on the right side, 9 minus 9 makes 0. On the left side, we'll have x squared minus 8x minus 9. We've done a whole bunch of factoring already, and now we're going to do a little bit more of it. Let's get our two parentheses, set it equal to 0, and we need two numbers that multiply to negative 9, but add to negative 8. Well, you can make negative 9 by saying negative 9 and 1. Negative 9 plus 1 makes the negative 8 that we're after in the middle. So we'll have x minus 9 and x plus 1. Now we are just going to solve each piece of the equation. If we have x minus 9 equals 0, our answer will be x equals 9. For the other piece, if we have x plus 1 equals 0, we'll just move the 1 over, and we'll say x equals negative 1. Those are our two possible solutions. We need to check to make sure that when we put them back into the equation, we don't get anything we're not supposed to. To do that, we're going to reset the equation, log base 3 of x minus 8 equals 2 minus log base 3 of x, and try putting in 9. Specifically, we want to make sure that there are no negative logs. So let's try 9. We'll let x equal 9. Log base 3 of 9 minus 8 equals 2 minus log base 3 of 9. If we simplify this, we'll have log base 3 of 1 equals 2 minus log base 3 of 9. You could continue to simplify this if you desire, but in most cases, it's enough to know that there are no negatives inside the log. So I don't see any negative numbers inside of these logs. So x equals 9 is going to be okay. Now let's try x equals negative 1. Let's put that into the top equation. We'll have log base 3 of negative 1 minus 8 equals 2 minus log of negative 1. We can already see that there is a negative number inside of the log. And if you take the log of a negative number, you will not get a real answer. Anytime you get a not real answer, the negative 1 is not a real solution. So our only answer is going to be x equals 9. If you gave x equals negative 1, they would not count that correct. So that is how you take a logarithm equation, change it into a quadratic equation, and then solve it using methods you already know. But for logarithm problems, make sure that you don't get any negatives inside the logs, or else it's not really a solution. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again next episode.